Welcome to Today's Farm Life. I'm at the Deinert family farm just west of Mitchell, talking with Kevin Deinert, who farms with his brother Mike and his dad Ron. This field being cut for silage, and Kevin agreed with me that this year going in, I had kind of a question mark about the silage, but once they got into it, it's somewhere between shocked and amazed. It looks pretty good.
Yeah, we started great planting conditions. I mean, wonderful planting conditions. It's the best we've had in a few years now. I actually could plant fence row to fence row, which has been an oddity the previous years, but throughout the year, obviously very warm through the summer. Crops were noticeably stunted, I mean, just within height and pollination. Even there's pollination issues. But got toward the end of the year, we caught maybe a few rains that could have helped some test weight, and remarkably, the corn looks decent. Like I said, considering the type of year we had and the level of drought that we are in, its corn has done decently well. I'm hoping when the adjuster comes out, he says around 150 bushel. And I think that's a pretty realistic goal, considering what I've heard around the state has done so far. You know, I've heard anywhere from 50 to 200. So I think I'm hoping for 150 bushel. It looks like it could do that. Obviously, there's good spots and there's bad spots. So hoping for that good average, about 150 bushel. Corn this year has dried down fairly quickly. Part of that due just to maturity days. We've had a lot of warm days, so a lot of growing units that went into that plant pretty quickly. Kernel moisture, we're running anywhere from maybe half milk line down to maybe high 20s moisture. And I'm sure it's gonna keep on coming down quicker every day. And I think people are gonna be combining corn before they're gonna be doing any soybeans here.
According to Deinert, it's not been officially tested yet, so we don't know the official numbers, but he said from what he sees taken out of this field, the quality looks pretty good too.
So silage usually kind of a twofold deal, how little ton out per acre. And then, you know, silage in general is only as good as the corn that's in there. You know, how well much corn is in there. Tonning out fairly decent, maybe 12 to 14 ton an acre. So there's still some good mass there within that corn plant that had hung on throughout the year and helped ton out pretty good. Again, corn-wise, as far as appraisal or the yield-wise for that field, it's done pretty decent. I think we'll help feed value on that. And until we send in for further tests as far as protein and all that good stuff, just kind of by the eye test, that's what we're seeing so far.
Opening up the field for silage cutting is almost like we opened the door for the harvest season, which is just around the corner. Which reminds me, be sure and sign up for the Harvest Helper Award. I could be bringing lunch to your field, and we could award one of your workers with the Harvest Helper Award. It's a prize package worth about $400. So be sure and sign up. You can't win if you don't sign up. Go to todaysfarmlife.com, go to the harvest page, get all the details. Remember, feel good about what you do today, because what you do today is very important. For Today's Farm Life, I'm Doug Cunningham.